Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how you can use Character Creator 4 as a pose library source and custom pose tool for your character models in ZBrush. If you're not familiar with how to install the Pose Tools plugin for ZBrush or the Pose Link plugin for Character Creator, please refer to our installation tutorial. Let's get into the basic setup first for our ZBrush character. For this video, we're going to be using this pirate character, which you see here. He's made up of multiple subtools and a total of 299,639 quads. In order to use CC4 as our source pose library, we need to start by using AccuRiG to auto-bind the skeleton for this character. Please be aware that the ideal quad count for models sent into AccuRiG is under 300,000. Therefore, in this pipeline, if you need to sculpt model details which require high quad counts, please use the subdivision features in ZBrush first. If your character already has more than 300,000 quads, you can also consider using ZBrush's other project features to optimize your model. We will have another tutorial on this as well. It's important before exporting to ensure that your model's physical size is consistent with CC4. You'll find size unit parameters at the top of the Pose Tools plugin. There are some height presets for either metric or imperial measurements, or you can use the slider to set it manually. If your character contains layers, please bake them to the character first to ensure uniform resizing. Once you're satisfied, click on the Resize button and confirm the model size. Once that's taken care of, we can send the model to CC4 via GoZ, which will send the currently selected subtool. All can be used to send over all of the subtools. In CC4, the GoZ options panel will pop up showing the meshes that will be imported. Ensure that Create Prop is selected for all action options, and then click Update to import the meshes. Okay, now we need to use AccuRiG to bind the skeleton for the character, so let's select the pirate and enter into AccuRiG mode. The first step is to automatically detect the character's joint positioning. So generally we'll want to hide all of the extraneous accessories and choose selected meshes as the target mesh with the nude body mesh selected for best initial results, and choose force symmetry since our character is symmetrical in this case. After clicking Create Guides, the character's joint markers will be generated. If you wish, you can choose different display settings including wireframe on shaded mode to get more accurate placement. You can adjust the markers using the reference dummy image on the top right as a guide for where each marker should be placed. Symmetry selection is enabled here, so any movement on one side of the character will be copied to the other side as well. Finally, set the number of fingers for your character and click on Generate Skeleton to produce our skeletal rig. Here you can adjust the bone color to see it better, and also refine the positioning of the generated bones. If I select a finger bone and press the F hotkey, that will focus my camera on that bone. Here, I'll want to ensure that the finger bones are also correct, making sure to rotate the cone dummy so that it is pointing outwards from the surface of the thumbnail. The last step in AccuRiG is to bind the skin weights. You'll notice here that there are some solid separate meshes like the sword, gun, and rings that we do not want to bend or conform to body movements, as they will be separate accessories later. Therefore, what I want to do is select all of the meshes of items related to body parts and conforming clothing items, and then select Bind Skin. Again, ensuring that selected meshes is selected. Processing time may vary here, depending on the complexity of your character and the speed of your computer. Once binding is complete, the skeleton color will change, and you'll notice that the hard objects we didn't select earlier are now classified as separate accessories. You can now exit AccuRiG mode and click on each accessory to see which bone it has been attached to. Use the calibration motions from the timeline to ensure that the results are satisfactory. You can always go back and click on the Skin Weights button to check the skin weight distribution for each bone on the skin and clothing meshes, and manually paint them to make improvements. Okay, now that your character is fully rigged, it's time to relink it. Start by selecting all of the meshes and clicking on Go Z. Choose Relink from the template dropdown and then click on Go Z. This will update the model in ZBrush, and you can now send poses between the two programs. To transfer a pose over to ZBrush, simply select your preferred option from the ZBrush Pose Link plugin menu. You can import in both T and A poses by selecting that option, after which they will appear in your ZBrush Pose Tools, where you can alternate between them. You'll also see if you expand the Layers tab that each pose will add a layer to each subtool. Back in Character Creator, you can find a number of free embedded animations and poses in the Content Manager under Free Resources. If I apply this sitting animation, I can scrub through the timeline to find the frame that I want, and then under the ZBrush Pose Link plugin, choose Send Current Pose to ZBrush Pose Tools. This will send the character in that pose to ZBrush under the name Pose 1, and we can see that the CC Pose underscore Pose 1 layer will be created. You can deselect it to restore the original A pose. I'll repeat the process again with a different frame of the animation, and you'll see it creates another pose called Pose 2. I can rename any of the poses I import simply by using the Rename button below. ReIllusion provides a comprehensive library with thousands of animations that you can access from ActorCore, the content store, or the marketplace. Since this character was rigged with AccuRiG, it is compatible with all of these motions, and you can also utilize Human IK enabled motion editing with the Edit Pose tool in CC4 for further customization. This tool also includes the ability to edit smaller details like finger and hand gestures. You can learn more about pose editing from the dedicated tutorials. The Edit Pose tool can be used to tweak the pose of a specific frame of any animation you like. In this case, I've chosen a frame of a shooting animation, and after I'm finished tweaking the pose, I can make my gun accessory visible and position it properly while using the same tool to refine the finger position as well. I can then once again send the current pose to ZBrush using the same process. It's always a good idea to rename your poses right off the bat to keep things organized. Since this character has a number of different weapons, we can send over different relevant poses, ensuring we also position those accessories correctly. You can also edit the active pose directly in ZBrush as well by clicking on the Edit Current Pose button. This will switch the respective subtool layer, in this case CC Pose underscore Shooting 1. You'll see the little record icon beside it, which indicates record mode, allowing you to transfer or sculpt the mesh. Here what I'm doing is a bit of mesh editing on the trousers to make the fabric seem a bit more puffy. Since we use AccuRiG to do automatic rigging and skin weights, certain elements like baggy fabric may not perform ideally when your character is in a certain pose. Therefore, you may need to do some manual editing in ZBrush to differentiate the folds and drape of the fabric from the limbs or body of your character for more realistic visual results. The position of certain accessory meshes may need to be adjusted depending on your character's pose as well, like this sword here. In addition to simple mesh editing, you can also increase the subdivision level of the model in order to sculpt in more detail. There are also some subdivision level presets in the plugin that allow you to change all of the subtool division levels at once without needing to adjust them individually. all low and all high, switch all subtool levels to the highest or lowest subdivision level. Lower res and higher res, adjust all subtools level by level. Finally, the divide button will add a subdivision level. Increased subdivision levels allow you to add more details to elements like skin wrinkles, muscle shapes, veins, and more. Once you're finished editing, click the Save Current Record button to close record mode. Okay, finally, let's save our project. When we want to save and be able to continue editing in the future, we can simply use the Control S hotkey to save a ZPR file. In CC4, you can click on the Save button in the Content Manager to save the project, which will save to the Custom tab. It's important to note that when we open the ZPR file again, there won't be anything in the pose list. To bring those back, simply click Refresh Pose List, which will populate the list with the data from the Layers section. You can double-check all of these to ensure that they are satisfactory. From there, you can load the same project from CC4 and continue to apply motions and poses, which you can transfer quickly to ZBrush using the pipeline. In the end, Character Creator contains a massive embedded motion library with the option to purchase additional motions and poses from our various online marketplaces. This provides unlimited pose potential for your character in ZBrush, and it has never been easier to update poses from one program to the other. That's it for this video, guys. Thanks to the Pose Tools and Pose Link plugins, ZBrush users now have a more optimized workflow for bringing character poses back and forth, saving huge amounts of time and avoiding frustration. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.